Chapter 131, Your girlfriend will be mad. Liu Xiaoxiao looked at the time and grimaced. Looking anxious, she said to Liu Yichen, I'm sorry. I have to go. She had been out for almost an hour. If she did not return soon, Yin Shouji might realize that she had slipped away. Okay. Liu Yichen nodded and asked the waiter for the bill. Liu Xiaoxiao felt awkward. Why not, let's go Dutch. Liu Yichen gave the money to the waiter, and he laughed and said to her, it's fine. How about this? I'll treat your time, and you'll treat me next time, all right. Liu Xiaoxiao nodded without hesitation. Okay, then, she thought. Next time, I'll treat him something good and definitely more expensive. Liu Yichen suddenly thought of something. He looked at her and asked, how about treating me to a movie? There's a film from America screening this weekend. It's something I've always wanted to watch. I don't know if you would be interested. That movie. I like it too. Okay then, I'll treat you to the movie. Liu Xiaoxiao hastily replied. Then, she suddenly paused and she recalled that he had a girlfriend. She looked at him hesitantly. Wouldn't it be inappropriate for the two of us to go watch a movie together? What's wrong with that? Liu Yichen asked her, seeming puzzled. Liu Xiaoxiao laughed bitterly as she looked at him. Don't you have a girlfriend? If she knew, she would be mad. Why not do this instead? I'll treat you, and you take your girlfriend to the movie. Would that be good? Liu Yichen paused for a moment, and he suddenly smiled. Liu Xiaoxiao couldn't understand what his expression meant. Was he smiling in agreement or disagreement? However, she was resolute. If he had a girlfriend, she definitely wouldn't accompany him to the movies alone. She had to avoid arousing suspicion. Suddenly, Liu Yichen met her gaze and said unexpectedly, actually, I don't have a girlfriend. Ah. Liu Xiaoxiao was dazed. Liu Yichen had a faint smile. I said that I have no girlfriend, so you can still take me to the movie. But no, you don't have a girlfriend. That can't be. Don't you have a girlfriend? Liu Xiaoxiao could not comprehend what he had said. If she had heard from just a single person, it could very well be false. But not only Yu Zhe, Yin Shouji had also said that he had a girlfriend. She did not have to believe Yu Zhe. But even if Yin Shouji might be bossy and petty sometimes, she still believed his words. Liu Yichen touched his nose looking slightly embarrassed as he said, I lied about having a girlfriend. Liu Xiaoxiao was stunned. Who would have thought? She immediately thought about something related and cried in surprise, could it be that you used it as an excuse to reject the girls who confessed to you? Then as time passed, everyone began to think that you really had a girlfriend. No wonder. They said that his girlfriend was mysterious and that no one had ever seen her or knew which school she went to. As it turns out, his girlfriend never existed. Liu Yichen signaled her to keep quiet. His handsome face looked serious, and he said, no one else knows about this. You have to keep it a secret, all right. Okay. Liu Xiaoxiao nodded with a blank expression as she had yet to recover from the sudden revelation. Liu Yichen looked at her odd expression, and he narrowed his eyes and asked, you look like you are disappointed. Chapter 132, feeling guilty for lying. Liu Xiaoxiao's eyes widened, and she immediately shook her head. No, I'm not. You're mistaken. Sigh. She was a little disappointed because she had initially thought that the matter about his girlfriend was very mysterious, and it had piqued her curiosity. She had wanted to find out the. She was disappointed because she couldn't feel the joy of investigating anymore. Then we'll agree on watching the movie this Saturday. Liu Yichen stopped probing into the matter. Sometimes, her feelings would show clearly in her expression. With one glance at her, he understood and didn't feel the need to continue questioning her. Liu Xiaoxiao didn't think that there was any problem with the plan, and she nodded her head, saying, okay. So, I'll see you then. I really have to go now. As he watched her small figure running out frantically, Liu Yichen smiled. Back at the apartment, Liu Xiaoxiao stealthily opened the door and carefully closed it behind her. Bending her waist at the entrance, she was very lightly taking off her slippers. Suddenly, a shadow was cast on her petite figure. An icy voice came from above her, "Where did you go?" Liu Xiaoxiao was motionless. She slowly raised her head and met Yin Shouji's stern expression. She hollowly laughed and asked, when did you realize I was gone? Half an hour ago, Yin Shouji stared at her with his eagle-like eyes as if he was watching his prey. Liu Xiaoxiao suddenly brought out a bag from behind her, and she smiled. It just happened to be tea time when I woke up, so I went downstairs to buy something myself. Yin Shouji was not that easily fooled. He smiled and looked at her doubtfully. And you went out for half an hour. Which store did you buy it from? Seeing the store's name on the plastic bag, he confirmed that it was a store from nearby. In truth, it wasn't that Miu Xiao Xiao was shrewd. She happened to pass by the store as she was returning and caught a whiff of the fragrance. She started craving it, so she bought some food. Little did she know that it would serve as a good excuse. Miu Xiao Xiao's eyes darted around. Yeah, I met a Samoyed, and it was too cute. I had to play with it for a while. After that, I went to buy the food. Wow, the story is flawless. She was impressed by herself. Yin Shouji narrowed his eyes. Samoyed, I have stayed here for a long time, and I haven't seen any before. How old was it? What's its name? Is the owner a man or a woman? Miu Xiao Xiao was speechless. How would she know all this? She hadn't really met a Samoyed. She was frantic for a few seconds. Suddenly, she regained composure and stared at him as she said, what's the meaning of this? You don't trust me. HMPH. Shame on me for treating you well and buying your favorites. Now you won't have any of it. She feigned a fit of rage and was about to pass by him to enter the apartment. Yin Shouji grabbed her hand, and he looked at her helplessly, okay. Why are you so angry? I didn't say that I don't trust you. I was just curious. You have injuries, yet you still went out. You should have at least told me. He pulled her as they walked to the sofa. He took the bag from her hands and placed it on the coffee table. Miu Xiao Xiao was already feeling guilty and she didn't continue the act lest she exaggerated it and raised his suspicions. Just as the two were eating, her phone suddenly rang. Chapter 133, So She Did Like Him. Miu Xiao Xiao paused for a moment as she wondered if it might be Lu Yichen who had called. She instinctively glanced at Yin Shouji. And he looked back at her coincidentally. His gaze was so deep it was terrifying, and it was as if he had seen through her. Your phone is ringing. Aren't you going to answer? He reminded as he stared at her, putting her on edge. Miu Xiao Xiao had no choice but to force herself to answer the phone. Upon seeing the caller ID, it turned out that the caller wasn't Lu Yichen but Ha Qiqing. She let out a breath of relief. Smiling as she boldly showed the screen to him, she said, it's Little King calling. Oh, why would she be calling you so suddenly? Miu Xiao Xiao was stunned. If he knew that she had met with Ha Qiqing just now, then he would find out about her lie. She stammered nervously, I don't know, let me answer the call first. She was afraid that Ha Qiqing would expose her, so she left the sofa and walked towards the fridge while pretending to get water. Yeah, Ha Qiqing's voice sounded like a machine gun as she said, Xiao Xiao. What exactly is going on between you and Lu Yichen? When did you first meet him? Why would he be having a meal at the coffee shop with you? Do you like him? Boohoo. Don't tell me. Don't tell me. I don't want to know. Boohoo. Miu Xiao Xiao pulled the phone away from her ear for a short while and then put it back. You, calm down. Can you lower your voice? I almost went deaf. You're going deaf, but my heart's breaking. Xiao Xiao, do you know how long I've liked him? How could you, snatch my prize? Boohoo, I feel like dying now. Xiao Xiao, we've been such good friends. How could you steal my love, Boohoo? Hearing that, Miu Xiao Xiao was between laughing and crying. However, that confirmed her earlier suspicion that she was indeed fond of Lu Yichen. I'm not. Oh yeah, she glanced at Yin Shouji out of the corner of her eyes. While he wasn't watching her, she slipped into the bedroom and closed the door. Though she knew the room had good soundproofing, she still warned Ha Qiqing in a soft voice, you have to keep our meeting today a secret. Don't tell anyone, especially Yin Shouji. You can't let him know. Why? Ha Qiqing did not understand. I'll explain next time. Just remember what I said. Don't let him know. Got it. Oh, I got it. So you and Lu Yichen, Miu Xiao Xiao quickly clarified, I'm only friends with him. If you like him, stop worrying and go pursue him. Okay. Ha Qiqing sighed and said dejectedly, I did pursue him. But I couldn't reach him, he didn't pay me any attention. So when she saw Lu Yichen eating out with Miu Xiao Xiao, she had been very surprised. She had admired Lu Yichen for a long time, but she had never seen any girl spending time with him alone. Oh, Miu Xiao Xiao recalled when she first met Lu Yichen that he had been grave and stern, and he was blunt when he rejected girls. She could imagine that Ha Qiqing's pursuit for his love had been an arduous one. Ha Qiqing sighed. Sigh, I know he has a girlfriend. So for now, I can only watch him from afar. Miu Xiao Xiao was speechless. She felt a great urge to tell Little King. Lu Yichen doesn't actually have a girlfriend. But she had promised Lu Yichen to keep the secret. She couldn't say it, not even to her good friend. Chapter 134, Young Master Ji, you have been cuckolded. Just as Miu Xiao Xiao entered school today, she noticed something odd with the atmosphere. Ever since she entered through the entrance, people had been wagging their tongues as they lowered their heads and stared at her. Miu Xiao Xiao felt very uneasy, as if she was a monkey in an exhibit. Passing by the notice board, she saw Yu Jie running towards her, looking serious. He then grabbed her and said frantically, "Xiao Xiao, come see this quickly. What is the matter with this?" "What?" Miu Xiao Xiao looked confused as she followed him. The crowd before the notice board saw that she was here and they opened a path for her. Miu Xiao Xiao had an ill premonition and she walked over to take a look. There was a photo on the notice board. It was a photo of Lu Yichen and her having a laugh in Blue Cafe. The photo was even taken very beautifully. One would only think of adultery upon looking at the photo. She was stunned. "Who put this up?" Yu Jie shook his head and brought out his phone. "I don't know. Take a look. It's even on the web forum. People have also shared it across every class's group chats. The situation is bad. They're all spreading a rumor about you." He didn't dare to continue speaking. Seeing his look of hesitation, she knew it wasn't anything good. How did it turn out like this? Who's the culprit? Miu Xiao Xiao was about to blow her top. She only had an innocent meeting with Lu Yichen. How could it turn out like this? The crowd was pointing fingers at her. It was as if they were poking her brain, giving her a huge headache. Yu Jie frowned and said, "I suspect it was Hazue. She's the greatest suspect. The school already expelled her because of what happened to you. Given her personality, she would definitely hold a grudge and take revenge against you." "She's expelled." Miu Xiao Xiao hadn't thought about that. Having heard what Yu Jie had said, she thought that that would indeed be the most plausible cause. Yu Jie said, "Yeah. You should know that expulsion from Shengde is extremely severe. Studying in Shengde is a symbol of status. If she was expelled, her reputation among the rich and powerful families will be ruined. Moreover, given Ha Zue's huge ego, she won't stand for such humiliation." Miu Xiao Xiao could only feel a throbbing pain in her temples. She wasn't worried about Ha Zue's revenge, but, "Xiao Xiao, what's happening?" Yin Shouji's attractive voice suddenly came from behind. Miu Xiao Xiao was stiff and motionless. She didn't dare to turn around and look back at him. Before Yin Shouji could see the photo on the notice board, someone from the crowd reported, "Young Master Ji, you've been made a cuckold. Miu Xiao Xiao and Lu Yichen are together. A woman like her is not compatible with you. Break up with her." "Yeah, a fickle girl like her is not deserving of Young Master Ji. It would be too easy on her if you only broke up with her. Expel her from the school." "Yeah, get her out of the school. Expel this slut." The ones denouncing Miu Xiao Xiao in the crowd were mostly girls. "What's going on?" Yin Shouji frowned as he looked at her. He looked up and saw the photo on the notice board, and his expression instantly turned cold. He turned his cold gaze towards Miu Xiao Xiao, and he asked again, "What's going on?" The same words were spoken, but his tone and the meaning implied was different. "When was this photo taken?" he asked rationally, looking at the photo again at the bottom right-hand corner where the date was printed. "This time, isn't it?" Chapter 135, extremely enraged, Miu Xiao Xiao. "You lied to me," Yin Shouji said in a chilly voice as he stared at Miu Xiao Xiao in anger. "Ji, hear me out. It wasn't intentional. Miu Xiao Xiao panicked. She didn't know how she could explain herself. The evidence was there. Whatever she said would be a lie." Yin Shouji quickly walked up to the notice board and tore down the photo. He shredded the photo into pieces, turned around, and threw them onto Miu Xiao Xiao. He didn't say a word as he glared at Miu Xiao Xiao, his chest rising and falling as if he was containing his rage. For the first time, Miu Xiao Xiao experienced firsthand what it meant to say, "The truth always comes out. There is no concealing the truth." She had just never imagined that this would be how she would be exposed. Someone wanted to harm her and incite a fight between her and Yin Shouji. They succeeded. Yin Shouji scoffed, "Tell me. I want to see what kind of excuses you can come up with this time to fool me. Why aren't you speaking? Tell me." Miu Xiao Xiao was startled by his strict, loud voice, and she winced, her face in a grimace as if she was about to cry. Yin Shouji raised his head with his fists clenched tightly, and he suddenly kicked the rubbish bin at the side to the ground. "No crying. You're hoping that I will go soft on you. Miu Xiao Xiao, I am realizing, for the first time, that you are really cunning. If you don't want to explain, then don't ever speak about it. With that said, he kept an impassive face as he turned around and left. Lin Shouji. Niu Shaoshao frantically called him as she chased up to him, hoping to explain and apologize. However, Yu Jie held her back. Yu Jie said worryingly, Shaoshao, don't go. Things can only go wrong if you go to him now when young Master Ji is so infuriated. Let him calm down and explain it to him later. But Niu Shaoshao was anxious, and tears were seeping through the corner of her eyes. It's useless if you go to him now. Young Master Ji won't be able to hear what you have to say. What's more, the evidence was laid bare. How are you going to explain that to him? I knew Shaoshao was at a loss. How should she explain it to Yin Shouji? The concern was no longer about her relationship with Liu Yichen but that she had lied to Yin Shouji. She wondered, was he angry because of this? However, she still couldn't understand why he was so angry over just a little lie. Niu Shaoshao even felt a bit wronged. She could have apologized, and he didn't have to be so angry as if she had really made him a cuckold. At this moment, the bell rang, and Yu Jie said, okay, let's get back to class first. Then, you can look for young Master Ji again after school to explain yourself. Niu Shaoshao was very confused and couldn't think of any solutions. Thus, she just went along with Yu Jie's advice. However, she was still lost in thought during the lesson. The English teacher suddenly called her up to read a paragraph of the text. She wasn't even paying attention and confused her lines. What are you reading? What a mess. Niu Shaoshao, don't get conceited just because you studied in America. You have much more to learn. Sit down and pay attention, okay? English teacher was mocking her slightly. He was delighted as he had finally gotten his revenge on her. In the past, Niu Shaoshao would not have stood for such humiliation. But now, she could only think about how she was going to explain herself to Yin Shouji, and she didn't even realize how the English teacher was treating her. Chapter 136, Sticking Up for Her. Thud thud. The English teacher knocked his pointing stick on Niu Shaoshao's table, his face showing delight. He then raised his head and said to everyone, you should not be like Niu Shaoshao, thinking that you don't have to learn English just because you can speak it well. After all, conversations and examinations are not. Before he could finish speaking, as he was walking up to the podium, a leg suddenly extended below. As he lifted his head in delight, he didn't see the leg and tripped over it. He stumbled and nearly fell, but he clung onto the two tables beside him in an embarrassing posture and finally steadied himself. Some of the students muffled their laughter. The English teacher looked grim. After he stood steadily, he turned to look at Yu Jie and said, Yu Jie looked all innocent as he shrugged his shoulders and said, I'm sorry, teacher. I didn't mean it. In fact, he did mean it. His mouth revealed a faint smile that was too obvious, and his manner of apologizing was too insincere. With that said, Yu Jie glanced at Niu Shaoshao with a smile as if he was taking credit for helping her. The English teacher was red in the face. However, he couldn't do anything to Yu Jie, and he had no choice but to swallow his anger. Be careful next time. Don't put out your legs. It's okay if I fall, but what if other students fell? Having explained in a calm and collected manner, he stood erect and displayed a confident posture. He glanced down and saw that Yu Jie's leg was still extended, and he decided to cross over. However, Yu Jie suddenly retracted his leg. Seeing that, the English teacher also instinctively withdrew his attempt to cross over. In a turn of events, the English teacher's posture was unstable, and he lost balance and fell to the ground. Ha 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 ha, the students couldn't help but laugh out loud as the sight was simply too comical. However, each laugh felt like a slap to his face. The English teacher looked grim. Yu Jie clicked his tongue and said, sounding concerned, teacher, why don't you be more careful? I have already retracted my leg, yet you fell again. You won't blame me, will you? Niu Shaoshao stared blankly as she finally realized that Yu Jie was sticking up for her. The English teacher was practically crawling to his feet. The student's laughter had left him completely humiliated. Without waiting for his dismissal, the students left on their own. Niu Shaoshao was unsure whether to laugh or cry. She was only in a daze for a while, and trouble had already occurred. In contrast, Yu Jie was feeling joyful. He turned his head to her and placed his hands overlapped on her table, looking as if he was seeking praise from her. How was it? I avenged you. How do you intend to thank me? Treat me to lunch. Actually, I wasn't offended earlier, Niu Shaoshao smiled grudgingly. The English teacher thought that he had made her sullen, but she wasn't paying attention and hadn't even put the matter to heart. UJ humped and said, "Didn't you see his face? Damn, just looking at that puts me in a bad mood. He was deliberately causing your trouble and even secretly enjoying it. That's disgusting. Okay, okay. What's done is done. Don't go overboard next time." Miu Xiaoxiao didn't want to reprimand him as he had just stuck up for her after all. The next lesson was physical education class. Miu Xiaoxiao sat at the steps at the side, still hesitating about whether to find Yin Shouji to apologize despite Yu Zhe's advice to find him after he had some time to calm down. However, she still thought that it was best to approach him immediately to apologize and explain herself. Chapter 137, You Have Been Abandoned. Suddenly, a shadow flew toward her. Bang! She was hit in the forehead. A ball bounced on the floor and rolled to one side. Ouch! Miu Xiaoxiao cried out in pain, nearly falling back from the force she had received. I'm sorry. A girl ran to her and gave her a casual apology before picking up the volleyball and returning to the court. Miu Xiaoxiao rubbed her forehead, feeling as if her head was swaying. How could she be so unfortunate? She had been hit by a ball while spacing out. Since physical education lesson is just sitting around and wasting time, why not go to Year 2's class as to secretly check on Yin Shouji? Just as she made her decision, another shadow suddenly flew toward her again and hit her on the head. She could already feel her head spinning before, and now, she felt even dizzier. Her vision went dark, and Miu Xiaoxiao quickly held onto something beside her. I'm sorry, the same girl ran toward her again and said in a nonchalant voice. The first time could be an accident, but the second time definitely wasn't. It was obvious to Miu Xiaoxiao that it was intentional. Before she could get angry, Yu Zhe ran to her and said angrily to the girl, "You did that on purpose, didn't you?" He looked down at Miu Xiaoxiao with concern and said, "Xiaoxiao, are you all right?" Miu Xiaoxiao closed her eyes, her face in a grimace, seemingly in great discomfort. Yu Zhe saw the volleyball and knew that her head had to hurt. Thus, he glared fiercely at the girl. The few girls who were playing volleyball crowded around them, their faces acting apologetic. "Sorry, we really didn't mean it." No one told her to be sitting beside the court like a dummy. She didn't even try to dodge when the ball flew to her. Yu Zhe laughed grimly and said, "Dodge. Why don't you show me how you dodge?" The speed of the volleyball was too fast, and Miu Xiaoxiao had still been in a daze. How could she have dodged it? Even in a normal situation, it would have been hard to react quickly. The onlooking girls started whispering. Miu Xiaoxiao is really something. She has so many guys protecting her. Who knows how many people she has fooled around with. No wonder they say she is a fickle woman. From the looks of it, I'm guessing she must know some seduction techniques. Otherwise, how could she have charmed both young Master Ji and Lu Yichen? It is really a wonder what they see in her. Perhaps she is really flirtatious. Haha, it must be. Just look at her bosom. It's so well developed. One can imagine how flirtatious she can be. How can we even compare? That's right. Guys like big breasts. Their comments grew more unpleasant as they continued. They even said that she had been ridden by lots of men. Miu Xiaoxiao was already feeling dizzy, but she felt more uncomfortable hearing all these and couldn't help but retch. Xiaoxiao, are you okay? Yu Zhe stared at the girls and shouted angrily, "Shut up, all of you. Busybodies." One of them felt indignant and said, "Yu Zhe, you haven't fallen for her, have you? She is such a fickle woman, seducing men everywhere. Who knows how many men she has slept with, don't you find her dirty?" "Shut up." Miu Xiaoxiao was the one who howled this time. She grabbed the volleyball at the side and threw it right at the girl's forehead, and the girl fell back on her butt. The onlookers started to condemn her. "You, Miu Xiaoxiao, how can you use force on her? Don't think that you still have young Master Ji's protection. Now that he has seen your true colors, he won't keep you anymore. You have been abandoned." Chapter 138, If he doesn't want me, would he want you instead? If he doesn't want me, do you think he would want you? Miu Xiaoxiao scoffed at her. The girl had not expected her to retort in this manner, and she stared blankly for a moment before her face flushed with anger. However, she could not find the words to retaliate. Miu Xiaoxiao sneered and said, "With your looks, even if you went for plastic surgery, Yin Shouji would never fancy you. There is nothing for you to do but envy me. You, the girl was about to blow her top. Miu Xiaoxiao turned her attention and stared at the girl who slandered her and said haughtily, "I'm pretty, and I have a nice figure. What are you gonna do about it? I'm charming, and I can make guys treat me well. What are you gonna do about it?" TSK TSK. By the looks of the bunch of you, you must be extremely envious, huh? She had already been upset, yet they had still provoked her anyways. Did they think that she was a pushover? There was only one person in this world who could bully her, and that person is that rascal, Yin Shoji. The others could only wish. The girls who were told off were all grim-faced. Who's jealous of you? Mew Xiao Xiao, who do you think you are? Who's envious of you? Don't flatter yourself. For a fickle woman like you, there's nothing to be envious about. You're so dirty. I hope you don't catch those disgusting diseases. Enough. Yu Jie shouted at them as he could not stand it anymore. He held on to Mew Xiao Xiao and noticed that she looked pale. He asked her worriedly, how are you? Are you feeling unwell? Let me take you to the school's clinic to have a look, okay? Mew Xiao Xiao was fighting the discomfort and didn't want to appear weak in front of these people. She smiled provocatively at the girls and said, just wait and see. Didn't you say that Yin Shoji didn't want me? I will let you witness how much he likes me, how well he treats me, and how much he pampers me. I will make you die from envy. Hearing that, almost everyone thought that she had lost her mind from the nonsense she was spouting. Make young Master Ji like her. And pamper her. Hey hey, keep dreaming. Young Master Ji had dated so many girls, and they were all servile to him. Who had ever seen young Master Ji indulge any one of his girlfriends so excessively? That was utterly impossible. Yu Jie saw that Mew Xiao Xiao was swaying slightly as if she was going to collapse. He quickly grabbed her arm and was going to reach for her shoulder so that she could lean on him. However, Mew Xiao Xiao was not used to people being so close to her, and she shied away slightly. She knew that he had good intentions, and she smiled to him and said, I'm all right. Don't worry. Yu Jie frowned and said, I think you'd better go to the school's clinic to have a checkup or to rest. It's only physical education lesson. It's no big deal if you miss it. At this moment, a good acquaintance of Yu Jie approached and passed him the phone in his hand. I happened to record the event just now. Take a look. They smashed you on purpose. Hearing that, the girls who were playing started to panic. That is slander. We didn't do it on purpose. We can't control where the ball goes. Thanks, brother. Yu Jie took the phone and brought it before Mew Xiao Xiao, and the two watched the recording. The video was more than 10 minutes long. It reached the part where Mew Xiao Xiao was hit. It was clear that the girl who had swatted the ball was looking at Mew Xiao Xiao just as she hit the ball over to her. Chapter 139, Please Don't Be Angry Anymore. Yu Jie's blood boiled as he watched the video. After the girls had hit Mew Xiao Xiao once, they looked at each other, pleased, and continued their assault. If he had not stepped in, they might have done it 3 or even 4 times. The truth is right in front of your eyes. What else do you have to say? He turned the screen towards the girls in fury, putting it in the view of others at the same time to show that he had not slandered their reputations. The girls paled and did not dare to speak. Apologize. Yu Jie roared. The girls seemed reluctant and looked at each other. Frightened by Yu Jie's attitude, one of them began to bow to apologize. Sought suddenly, a girl stopped them. You don't have to apologize. Why should you? So what if you hit her? She isn't under the protection of young Master Ji anymore. Why should we continue to be scared of her? Even though Yu Jie's background was quite formidable, it was to be expected. Which student could get into class S if their background wasn't? The girl who stopped them had a background similar to Yu Jie's, so she was not afraid of him. Also, she was glad to help these people punish Mew Xiao Xiao, for she had been harboring resentment towards her. But the girl who had tried to apologize was a little worried about the harsh words Mew Xiao Xiao had thrown out arrogantly and of young Master Ji, who had expelled Ha Zue because of Mew Xiao Xiao and even stood up for her in public by punishing the girls who had bullied her. The girls' hearts were uneasy about how they had retaliated against Mew Xiao Xiao. What would become of them if what Mew Xiao Xiao had said was true and young Master Ji really cherished her? They may very well be the next one to get expelled then. It was a symbol of status to be able to study at Shengde High. If they were expelled, they would suffer at the hands of their families. After Ha Zue had been expelled, there were many who gloated over the fact in secret. No one wanted to experience a fate like Ha Zue's. When the girls had used the ball to hit Mew Xiao Xiao, it was actually because they had seen her spacing out and wanted to use the chance to vent their resentment towards her. They had thought that no one would notice if they had pretended that it had been an accident, since Mew Xiao Xiao looked like someone who could be bullied easily. Never had they expected that she would retaliate so strongly and cause the matter to blow up. The girls glanced at each other, the same thoughts probably going through their minds then. They ignored the girl who stopped them and bowed together before Miu Xiao Xiao. Sorry, it's all our fault. Please forgive us. They were now much more sincere after thinking about the possible threat of expulsion. However, half of the people still didn't believe that young Master Ji would look after Miu Xiao Xiao to such an extent. They felt that Miu Xiao Xiao's ego would only be inflated by the girl's apologies, so they continued to harbor feelings of resentment towards her. Miu Xiao Xiao felt really dizzy and was in no mood to continue the dispute. She waved them away, signaling that the matter was over. Xiao Xiao, are you going to let it pass just like that? Yu Jie seemed reluctant to do so. Miu Xiao Xiao sat down. It felt too uncomfortable standing up. Beckoning to Yu Jie, she signaled to him to hand his phone to her. Yu Jie was baffled but did so. Miu Xiao Xiao sent the video to her phone and edited it. She extracted the part where she was hit and looked like a pathetic joke before sending it to Yin Shouji. Ji, look, I'm so pitiful. Please don't be angry anymore, okay? She added a pitiable emoji that resembled being blasted into charcoal at the end of the message. Chapter 140, he's ignoring me. Yu Jie saw Miu Xiao Xiao frozen in this position and felt that something was amiss. Tapping her, he asked, Xiao Xiao, what happened? Are you okay? Her face looked paler than before, which made him worried. Miu Xiao Xiao's gaze lifted from her phone and she looked at him. Her face was streaked with sobs as she cried, Boohoo, he's ignoring me, who is he? Yu Jie asked in puzzlement, but something clicked in his mind. Could she be referring to young Master Ji? Looking dejected, Miu Xiao Xiao didn't reply to him. Yu Jie swept his gaze over the crowd, signaling that they should back off. Even though Miu Xiao Xiao was already feeling so uncomfortable, they were still surrounding her like that. Xiao Xiao, you don't look too good. Let me take you to the sick bay, okay? Miu Xiao Xiao did not protest this time and merely nodded her head obediently. She was still feeling dizzy and was worried that it was a concussion. She felt a little scared. Helping her up, Yu Jie took her out of the place. Luckily, the sick bay wasn't very far. However, Miu Xiao Xiao's head was bathed in the bright sunlight, causing her to feel even dizzier. She leaned onto Yu Jie unconsciously. Yu Jie had no choice but to hold her up by her shoulders, his face slightly flushed. When they finally arrived at the sick bay, the cool breeze of the air conditioner swept over them. It wasn't Miu Xiao Xiao's first time here. Looking at the familiar sick bay reminded her of the previous time when Yin Shouji stood up for her and she suddenly missed him. Was he still angry? She had even sent him such a pitiful video of her to appease him. Did his heart not soften after seeing it? Miu Xiao Xiao felt a little sad as she thought about this. She remembered that when she was little and had fallen down, he would imitate grandma and stand up for her by hitting the floor. But now, Xiao Xiao. A familiar voice suddenly interrupted her train of thought. Miu Xiao Xiao looked up in surprise. Seeing that it was Ha Qiqing, she asked, why are you here? Ha Qiqing was half laying on the bed and playing with her phone. She didn't look sick at all. Hee hee, Ha Qiqing chuckled awkwardly. I'm here to rest. What about you? Where are you feeling uncomfortable? Eh, this boy is, she noticed Yu Jie, who was practically embracing Miu Xiao Xiao. On the other hand, Yu Jie was astonished by the girl's interactions. Miu Xiao Xiao said, he sits in front of me. A wave of dizziness hit her, and Miu Xiao Xiao furrowed her brows in intolerance, her forehead breaking out in cold sweat. Ha Qiqing was a little shocked, but before she could react, Yu Jie quickly helped her over to a bed. Xiao Xiao, you should lie down. You'll probably feel better. Miu Xiao Xiao practically crawled up to the bed. Yu Jie even took off her shoes for her and made sure she was settled in before whispering, I'll call a doctor. Okay. Miu Xiao Xiao nodded. After Yu Jie had left, Ha Qiqing jumped down from her position on the bed and pulled a chair to Miu Xiao Xiao's bedside. Xiao Xiao, where are you feeling uncomfortable? You look bad, she said. Miu Xiao Xiao felt much better after laying down, feeling less dizzy than before. I was hit by a ball and I'm feeling little dizzy. Ha Qiqing looked at her with pity. Poor Xiao Xiao, you're so unlucky. Miu Xiao Xiao sighed but didn't reveal the truth, mainly because she was lazy too. She would do it when she recovered. I don't want to talk. Please don't talk to me anymore. Oh, I'll stay here with you.